Hello friends, welcome back. Now in this session you will see the parameters of or performance parameter of our operational amplifier. As I said in the previous class, there are several parameters: bandwidth, slew rate, open loop gain, common mode rejection ratio, power supply rejection ratio, input impedance, output impedance, and offset and drift. So now we'll see one by one bandwidth. First one is the bandwidth. So in this example, we will take the operational amplifier 741 for our explanation purpose. So now what is the bandwidth? Bandwidth is nothing but a range of frequency over which my amplifier works. I repeat, bandwidth is nothing but a range of frequency over which my amplifier works. If you take any amplifier, can it work on over any frequency? The answer is no. If you take any amplifier, it will work on particular frequency range that is called as a bandwidth. Now, this frequency range is related to the gain. So here I will try to draw x-axis, frequency, and y-axis is nothing but gain. Gain is nothing but AD. Y-axis is nothing but gain. 1 minute. I will try to draw. Y-axis is nothing but gain, and x-axis is nothing but frequency. That is, x-axis is nothing but frequency. Y-axis is nothing but AD. That is called as gain. Normally, AD, gain, is expressed in terms of dB. Gain is expressed in terms of dB. So now what is dB? dB means 20 log AD. This is the gain. So now at frequency 0 or at initial frequency, we will take this is the gain. This is our gain at initial frequency. But now the question comes, if I use infinite bandwidth, that means infinite bandwidth means the frequency is infinite, then is this gain remains constant? No. After frequency of minus 3 dB, after frequency of minus 3 dB or after certain frequency, the gain actually decreases by 3 dB. So we will call this is 3 dB decrease, and then it will continuously reduce, and at particular point the gain reaches to 1. So AD is equal to 1. That means 20 log AD, 20 log 1 base 10 is equal to 0. That means when the gain is 0 dB, this curve will cross this curve or intersect this curve at particular point, and that particular point is called as unity gain bandwidth. That is called as unity gain UGB, unity gain bandwidth. So normally the bandwidths are expressed in two ways. The first way is sometimes they will express by UGB, unity gain bandwidth. So bandwidth represents the frequency range over which the amplifier works. This is the first one. Now, move on to the next parameter is called as slew rate. Slew rate is the parameter describes how quick the output changes to a particular value within a particular time period. For example, if the output of the operational amplifier changes to 4 volt within a microsecond or within second, then slew rate is we call 4 by 1 microsecond. If output reaches to 6 volt, then it is called 6 by 1 microsecond. That is called as a slew rate. So in the other way of explanation of slew rate is something like this. So this is the time and this is our input Vi. So initially we think our input is 0. Initially our input is 0. I make our input to 1, logical 1. I will make my input to logical 1. This is logical 1. Input to the logical 1. Now I will call this as a logical 1. But what about the output? As soon as I make my input out logical 1, whether the output changes in that sense field? No. Answer is no, because it takes some processing time or delay due to the other gates and processing delay. So my output is slowly rises and it overshoots, it will come down again and it will overshoot again and come down again, and finally it will settle. This is called as this settle. So now slew rate will measure by using this slope. The slope of this slew rate slope, the slope of this curve, for example, here, this is the change in the output voltage for this amount change in the time. So slew rate is normally expressed something like this: change in the output voltage divided by particular time. We will call it is in a micro or microsecond. We will call this is in a microsecond. So if you take one more waveform, something like this, the slew rate of this one is slower compared to slew rate of this one. So this is called as a slew rate. The third parameter is settling time. As I said, my output will raise, it will overshoot and it will come down, and it will overshoot, it will come down. So it will take and finally it will settle, but it will take infinite amount of time. It may take infinite amount of time to settle. So we cannot wait till then. So we will consider a particular range of tolerance band, and when the output reaches within that band, then we will say the operational amplifier is settled. So here I can say the operational amplifier output is in this range, so it is settled. And this is T2 and this is our T1. So this is the settling time of the operational amplifier. So this is the third parameter, settling time of our operational amplifier. So we have already studied now what is slew rate, and we know what is open loop gain. Open loop gain is nothing but it is nothing but AD, it is nothing but output voltage V0 with the input. Input is nothing but VD. What is VD? VD is nothing but difference in the input voltage between inverting and non-inverting terminal. This is called as open loop gain. Otherwise, open loop gain is the gain when we don't connect anything from the output to the input as a feedback. That is called as a open loop gain. So input impedance. So we have already know ideal operational amplifier. Input impedance is the input resistance between two terminal. For ideal operational amplifier, it is infinite. For practical operational amplifier, some input impedance is there. So in the same way, output impedance for ideal operational amplifier, the output output impedance is zero. But practical operational amplifier, the output impedance is in some ohm. So we have seen the settling time. As I said previously, see, this is called as a tolerance band for the settling time. So we have studied settling time and slew rate also. So with this, friend, we will see the rest of the parameters in the next session. Thank you.